control. And the camera being reversed from normal stuff is going to totally mess with me. Okay, now, I'm just going to say, I was playing this on my backing compatible PS3, but every time I collected a Precursor Orb, it like froze the game for like a full minute. So, oh, inverted look controls too. The Geyser and Geyser Rock. I understand the name now. Okay, so you know.
These floating egg-shaped things are Precursor
intro
orbs.
Level. It's gonna
collect
be.
Collect enough of them, and some of the villagers will give you a power cell in exchange.
I wish I could skip that. Yeah, I understand. Yeah, collect Precursor Orbs, trade for power cells. This, you know, collectibles. It's a platformer game. You don't really have to destroy these things, I don't think, but... Ah. You die. Yep.
This is a power cell. The most important precursor artifact you can find.
Yeah, like a levitating
shit. You need to collect 20 of these so I can power the heat shield for your A-grab tumor.
This is pretty cool. Alright, let's... Boom. And... Punch! Judo chop. Spikes are, they hurt you. They're not an instant kill, like they are in like certain games. I'm pretty sure. Yes, whatever. Saving. There we go. And yep, they're being the scout flies. Seven in each area. Seventh one will have a power cell.
You found one of my scout flies. I sent seven of them to each area to look for power cells, but the lurkers must have captured them all.
All of them. Every single one. And the boxes just scattered them all over the place. Because that's smart. Not just, you know, take the power cell from the last one. Oh, there's the geyser. Oh, there's the power cell. Four on Geyser Rock, so. Okay, I'm gonna get all four. And I probably should be able to fit this in one video.
Wow! That last scout had a power cell!
She's not annoying, though. She's not like an annoying character. There are annoying characters.
That's blue eco, which contains the energy of Moser.
You know.
Blue eco allows you to run fast.
Yeah, you can tell by the electricity that it looks like.
When you get near them.
Look at these imitations of lurkers. Like, oh wait. As I suspected, Precursor Orbs down here. Easy to miss, because it's not part of the actual, like, there is no power cell down here. But I will show you what Blue Eco does. It attracts, everything breaks boxes. Well, certain boxes. There's a special kind of box that can't be broken, like a strong box, I think it's called. Ooh, the spin jump doesn't work.
Notice how each Blue Eco cluster you pick up increases the time you can use its power.
You know. Tracks other tracks other blue eco and green. Big green is one health thing. At least the little green things are. And you see the health top right, top left over there. 50 there basically means that you have a fourth thing. You can't collect anymore. Like you have a fourth health block instead of the three that shape the heart. It's pretty cool. Okay, yeah. I like the uppercut that he does, and boom. Okay. And yes, the
precursor door. It can only be opened by approaching the door while channeling blue eco through.
As indicated by the symbol. Okay, R1 and L1 both spin, and spinning jump is probably the fastest way to get around. He has a blue eco vent.
More concentrated than the floating.
Fills up your gauge entirely.
This vent will give you a full charge of blue.
Which I don't know how many seconds it actually is. It might be like 45. It's like, that's why it's shaped like a clock, I think. Well, it's not shaped like it, it's a circle. So, whatever. Okay, and, okay, turn the camera. Power cell for opening a door. And there are easier power cells. And this whole place just looks cool.
Good work! The blue eco forced the door to open.
Like, this power cell right here froze my game for like 2 minutes. And it made the whole screen go green.
That have laid dormant for years.
Cool sound. Cool sound. Cool sound. Yeah, okay. Right here, these three. There's 50 on Geyser Rock, Precursor Orbs. Green Eco.
cells of energy on the ground.
Collected so much already, and now he explains it.
Pick up 50 small green eels or one big green one to increase your health.
I have to split the intro into one video and then just Geyser Rock. So two short videos, kinda. It's a 5-minute intro, really. Yeah, and then you spawn on Geyser Rock.
Then jump again in the air to reach even higher.
And here's
measures.
The 50th. Yeah. See, it shows you when you collect all of them. Jump across. Now, the camera, I swear to God, it's gonna mess me up so much. When you hit the stick to the right, it doesn't turn the camera to the right, it like swings it to the right. So like it really turns the camera left, like right, turns the camera left. Left turns the camera right. And okay. Awesome, like escalators. Another good jump is this one. Jumps higher if you jump after you do the square X thing. And yep. It's really weird that circle in this game is also like has the same functionality as the X when it comes to menus. Daxter.
Good training, boys. But that's nothing compared to the challenges that lie ahead.
Then no problem. We got the moves, eh, Jack? We'd love to stay and chat, Big Green, but we're, itching to get on with our adventures.
Fine, fine. Adventure away. And while you're out adventuring, why don't you make yourself useful? My darn green eco-collectors are clogged up again. Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps. They'll take you right there.
Follow the sound.
Now, all of you, get out of here!
Wasn't that loud. Okay, so I think this is where I'm going to try and end the video. If I have like a random thing, you know, it might be two short videos to begin with, and then we'll get into longer videos, because it's not just going to be like a bunch of short videos. So, I'll see you next time on Let's Play Jack and Daxter, The Precursor Legacy.